have one of our own, even though he's married, but they are still part of us. May I heartily welcome Mr. and Mrs. Testimony Okusi. If you find them in the house. He's part of us is Engineer and Mrs. K. Okay. By the boss, I might not get the son very well, but the northern president, Mr. Richard, Mr. and Mrs. Richard, please do the house. Mr. Yes, you know, God has a way of good things. He on the spirit of the condition, he just brought in one of our own, Mrs. Rejoice George. Please, man, I need to be happy. Yes, it's good to be married and be part of the CYM where everything is happening. Please let's clap for ourselves and welcome to the CYM. Also, we have the Mama President in our village, Mrs. Antonia Joe, the former CYM President of the CYM. Also, in our village, nobody that the President of the 6D Christian Youth Fellowship, Mr. Van Baruan, please and I will be the priest. And I will not forget to recognize the number one members of the church. And also for him to come give us his cocktail now. Please let's put our hands on our deputy, Mr.
First of all, I want to begin by thanking God Almighty for making today a possibility, irrespective of our challenges. But to thank God that today is here and it's happening. Praise the Lord. I am saddled with the responsibility to give some remarks so that we can charge the calls for this evening. The theme for this evening's forum is restructuring your finances to a better tomorrow. And we all selected this topic. So it wasn't a sole decision, it was a unanimous decision. And having considered the topic wisely, I want to, someone will ask, say, why would we talk about this topic, restructuring finances in a youth fellowship? Why would we talk about money to church? But to throw things in mind, I would like to read for a little Proverbs chapter 6, verse 6, so that we will understand that it is also God's will that we manage finances excellently. Because God gives us money. The Bible says the one that gives us power to make wealth. But He will not just give us the money and expect us to blow it all away. God's will for us is that the money He will give to us, the wealth He will give to us, will abide with us, and also it will increase. It will increase. In Isaiah 5 verse 11 says, He gives seed to the sower and bread to the eater. So He doesn't only give us bread to eat, He also gives us seed to sow, so that next time we can have bread to eat. Praise the Lord. So just to paraphrase that, Proverbs chapter 6 verse 6, it says, consider the ways of the ants, O sluggard, and learn our ways. It says, without the help of a leader or a director, they gather resources in the summer for the winter. Praise the Lord. And we are in a time in our country where, for the first time, everybody has left the world in recession. But you see, the will of God for His children is that we will not experience recession. There is no way you can cast and find recession. Joseph had a vision, he had a dream, and Pharaoh had a dream. and Joseph interpreted that dream. And that was a dream where God was warning Egypt that there was going to be a recession, a famine. And God gave Joseph wisdom on how they could restructure to prepare for that challenge. So we are here today to learn concerning that restructuring. So it's one thing to pray that God will make it to happen. But it's another thing to have the wisdom to preserve that armor that God will provide. Amen. So that's why we are here today. And by the grace of God, we are trusting God that we'll have more opportunities like this to learn. Because the essence of youth fellowship like this is not just for us to come and pray and see, but it's also for us to have wisdom and knowledge and understanding. Because without knowledge, we will do what? We will perish. Praise the Lord. And I'm sure it's not true for us to perish. So, to set the ball rolling, once again, I welcome to every one of us. And I want to implore us that it's not a wasted opportunity. Because I can guarantee you that what we'll learn today will help in one way or the other. It may not help us today immediately, but it will be the difference and to make the difference in our finances. Praise the Lord. So, at this point, I want to say once again, welcome. For those of us who are visiting us, for our guests, welcome. For our esteemed married senior colleagues, welcome. And for each and every one of us, once again, welcome. God bless us all. Fellowship. Right. Fellowship. Right. Fellowship.
Yes, they don't want to think about our churches. That's what we don't have to do here with us. I did want to use that business that our immediate past president of Zimbabwe that produced the current president of Zimbabwe. That is why we have democracy. Let us also welcome all the experts of the civil government of the United States with the people. If you know you are a representative of the civil government, with the communication of the community. With that, we speak much about time. We will